welcome to another exciting video. Actually, if you did, hang on, we've got a better idea. Quite fun actually. Welcome to another exciting video. So the first thing I played was something called a double stroke roll. Now I've done a lesson on the technique needed to help you play a double stroke roll. The lesson was basically doubles, so it relies on that rebound technique. But go back and watch the video because I spent a long time talking about that. Try and get that down, so master that, and then move on to this video. So this is called the double stroke roll. Or the long roll, purely because it just can go on for a very long time, or not necessarily that long, but it's definitely double stroke roll. Double stroke rolls, I think they're very useful in lots of music, classical music, orchestral music, brass band music, you name it, it's there. I like to learn them firstly, right, without, I was going to say concert band music as well. Learn them without any crescendos or decrescendos, because I was adding some dynamics into it when I was playing it a minute ago. So learn them just all even volume, so no ups and downs in volume, so no dynamics basically, or no ornaments. nothing too far out. Literally, just as they are, the bare essentials, right? So here we go, ready? Learn them slow to fast. So you need to go back and watch the doubles video for the technique. This is just showing you what double strokes rolls are, you know, in context. So with the crescendo and decrescendo for, I would say snare drumming in an orchestral sort of situation. So quite often, as I say, you'd add the dynamics in. So I like to start out here to get a real quiet, so like a piano, pianissimo, coming up to a fortissimo in the middle, because the middle's louder. Also, I've raised the height of my sticks as I go, so here we go, really. I am already starting at a fast speed. You can take them around the kit. You know, that's basically the double stroke roll or the long roll. You do hear them a lot actually in old fashioned movies, I find. So anyway, I also, as well as doing a double stroke roll or long roll, I also did a buzz roll, right? A buzz roll is also called a crushed or repressed roll. So a buzz roll is different to a doubles roll. A doubles roll is made up of two notes played in succession rapidly, one after another, as fast as you could humanly get it. Broadly speaking, that is. But a buzz roll is different in the sense that you don't have two clean notes per stick. So you don't have that. You don't have what you do when you play doubles, which is that. I was playing them slowly there, just to actually show you that I was striking two clean notes per hand or per stick. A buzz roll differs in the fact that it's multiple bounces. Yeah, that's quite a number per hand. I would, for the minute, try and get as many as you can off each hand as possible. Now, because I haven't talked about the technique for these, sorry, for this, the buzz roll, I'll try and explain it now. But don't think I was kind of, you know, trying to just do a quick video by not explaining the technique for the doubles. Please just look back over on the doubles video for that. Because I kind of, if I'd gone on about that in this video, we'd be here for another 10 minutes. And the point is just basically to show you doubles compared to buzz roll. And I need to get onto the buzz roll as quickly as possible to try and keep things rolling along and trying to keep it interesting. So on back onto the buzz roll, also called press roll, also called... Why it's called a buzz roll, by the way, is because it makes a bzzz. Yeah, that's the gist of it. Yeah, also called press roll. So the technique for it. Oh, crushed roll was the other way of explaining it. The technique for it is you basically keep these back three fingers off of the stick. Keep them clear of the stick. I leave her over. I'm pinching between my thumb and my index finger. Not really tight, because this will happen, you'll choke the stick. But also not really loosely, so that I lose all control and grip, whatever, and it all just falls apart. I can't get the buzz that way, you see, I'm just getting like clear notes. We don't want that, we want this. You can do it slowly. My motion is kind of that. My elbow comes out a little bit. And my palm is not down. It's nearer like a French grip position. So my palm is kind of more facing the other palm, if the other palm was there, if you like. Obviously the other palm's there when I'm playing, but it's not doing anything at the moment. I'm trying to show you just the right stick part. So there you go. Let's take that away for a minute, because I'm just trying to do one hand at a time. If you're right-handed, I would definitely start with your right hand. If you're left-handed, conversely, you start with your left hand. So right hand. So I'm trying to explain that I'm not really squeezing this stick to death, but I'm squeezing it a little bit to get that kind of buzzing feel. And you just let it keep going. You keep it just don't stop it from going. So if you span like a 10p piece coin or whatever, you just let it go until it goes all the way and stops. Same with this, I'm not trying to halt it, I'm not trying to go. Doing is I'm trying to get as many out of it as possible until it stops. I could do it faster, but I want to do it slowly for the minute, because I think if you do it slowly you get the kind of feel or the bounce, the kind of bouncy feel or the sensation you're trying to get from it. And if you can do it slow, it's easier fast. So kind of aim that. Yeah, I'm playing towards the rim. Why? Because it's an easy place to start. Why? Because it's bouncy there and it is there. Not a lot, but enough to make it easier. And you need it to be easy, because this is quite difficult. So that's my kind of movement. My thumb straight, actually. I end up kind of like that. There you go. I shouldn't have done that. I end up like that. I end up like that. Hang on. And as I make contact with the snare, I kind of look like that. So I'm definitely not doing the American or the German thing. So try and master that as much as you can. That is a tricky thing to do unless you're in a lesson. It's very difficult to try and emulate that, I understand that. But try your best, okay? Try and get it as good as you can with your right, as many bounces out of the right as possible. Once you think you've got that to a reasonable kind of state, move over to your left. Your left, if you're a right-hander, your left is always more difficult, yeah, we know, but just be so patient. The same thing, back three fingers off of the stick. When I say off of the stick, they kind of look like that. So I'm not trying to get any wings. They kind of end up in that position on both hands. There you go, roughly like that. Not, so they're kind of like that. They're not really stretched like that. They're not stretched out, rather. Not outwards, but more kind of like that. Again, the elbow comes up a little bit. The position, and I'm squeezing between the thumb, not too heavily in the index finger, but not so lightly that I drop it, drop the stick. Again, it's kind of that movement. So my palm would be facing the other one in that kind of position. It's not pure French grip, which is this. Pretty much, it's not that. I mean, it's pretty much, this would be French grip. Pretty much, that's how you play the French grip, but it's not that, it's more this. That's how it works for me. I know other people who kind of get a good buzz in that kind of position. You can do it in other positions. Look, ready? Here's the kind of good old German. I don't find it as easy, though. I find it better to have the hand so that the palm is not facing down. So it's more, as I say, like that. So try and get your left going, as many as you can, going out towards the rim. Not too fast, so I could go. This is how we're doing it for years, so you want to be, give yourself half a chance and not worry about it going slow. Plus, if you get it slow, you can get like the feel of what you're trying to get, as in terms of the multiple bounce. And if you can get those slow, eventually, therefore, it'll be easier to play them faster, okay? Try and conquer it slow. Get as many as you can. Just let the stick keep going until it stops. So once you've got that mastered, don't try and do this on pillows or cushions, right? Because some people say it's good practice to try and play doubles on cushions. If you're going to do that, please be careful, because you could actually injure yourself. Maybe watch a video from an expert trying to teach you how to play doubles off a cushion. I've never done it. I might have used off a pillow. I might have used cushions. The point is, if you play them on cushions or pillows, and if you can extract some kind of doubles out of cushions or pillows, the thinking is that then when you get onto a drum kit, which has some bounce in it, it's therefore easier than what it would be if you hadn't been practicing on the cushions or the pillows. But I probably wouldn't advocate that, and I wouldn't bother really doing that for a buzz roll, because that's going to be so, it's pointless. Don't do that, and you probably hurt yourself. Just get onto a drum kit or a rubber practice pad or a mesh head or something. Anyway, so you build them up slow on each hand, like you've done all the, when you did the drags and the roughs, you always work one side up, then the other side up, okay, and then you can start to alternate. So if you start slow and just increase the hand-to-hand pattern tempo just very slightly, so you're kind of, and the minute, yeah, so maybe, and the minute it goes wrong, start again. But imagine you've done this for a couple of weeks maybe, for say half an hour every other day, and you're kind of, you can see that by playing them, as one finishes, the other one sort of takes over, yeah? So it becomes a continuous buzz. Or a brrrr, it's more like a cement mixer, crikey. It's not called the cement mixer roll, yeah? Right, here we go. Long sustained buzzes and gradually increasing my hand to hand stick pattern, yeah. Actually, I've got a bit faster. Let me go like slowly and just build up very gradually to faster, right? An example of where that would be used that you might have heard or witnessed is, I don't know how many people go to circuses these days. That's probably where I first heard it, when I was about 7, I should think, in the circus in Bognor. Yeah, nice place, the circus in Bognor. At the time, the circus in Bognor was actually really cool when I was little. Circuses, I don't know if they're nice places or not, because of, you know, it's debatable, isn't it? Because, you know, compelling animals to do things when really they should be not kept in a zoo or a circus environment. So it's probably, they're not very nice really. But when I was 7 back in the day, I was enjoying the circus. And I was probably quite enjoying the snare drumming or drumming part of the circus, but didn't even realise it. But that's where I heard it. So that buzz roll could be used for the circus environment, all concert band and military band and march bands and orchestral stuff. But if we used it, if I demonstrate it for like a circus thing, definitely use the crescendos, yeah? Crescendos and decrescendos. So you'd start here, gradually get louder, move into the middle. Or you can start on the sides if you want. The reason you're starting there is because it's quieter. And when you come into this part of the drum, it's louder. Or as well as that, helping you increase the volumes because of the natural area of the drum, one part being louder than the other. Also lift, increase the height of the stroke, excuse me, the height of the stroke. So you'd be like, and end on like a crash cymbal with a bass drum, okay? So here comes the circus tightrope walker. It's meant to build suspense, isn't it, yeah? Here we go, really. And then starting here and coming to the middle. There you go. So, just to summarise, that was a lesson on the double stroke roll and the buzz stroke roll. Buzz stroke roll, also known as the press or the crushed roll. And hopefully that was very helpful. And thanks very much, and good night. Thank you. Thanks for watching that. Cheers. Bye.